in Raiford's Disco is a place unlike any other.
There's nothing else like that in America.
No matter if they're 21 or if they're 61, I tell them certain places to go eat, hang out, but I always say go to Raiford's.
It doesn't matter if you have $1 million or if you have $5. It does not matter. You can come to Raiford's and have the time of your life.
The music, the drum sets, I mean, it's just something that you like. You can't explain to somebody. You have to go.
If you were to take a drink of soul and then let that vibrate through your body, that's what you get here.
Memphis, without Paula Raiford's, it ain't Memphis.
And he opens, there's nothing downtown in Memphis, Tennessee. Literally, the Peabody had pigeons coming in and out of it. This corner right here, you could drive up and down at your own peril.
Raiford's, the club Raiford's was always that, it was so iconic in the streets. Hands down, it not only was it the place that you wanted to go when you were old enough to go, you tried to go before you were old enough.
You go to Beale Street, and I love everything on Beale Street. I'm not down on that. But Hollywood Raiford provided an experience you couldn't get anywhere else.
You felt like a star was riding around in your city. That's how he made you feel.
I was just blown away by his showmanship. I'm like, okay, he's a DJ, and he had the crowd just going crazy, and I'm just looking at this, like, mesmerized and taking notes at the same time. Like, this is how you do. This is how you entertain people. He was an entertainer.
65 came, and he's like, Paula returned this year, you know, and blah, blah, blah. And I believed him, so I started saving my money, and I'm going to retire too. So we all went home, and a couple guys came and wanted to open back up. My dad like, okay, I don't want to do anything but DJ. I think by him being the leader, it's hard not to be a leader. So he's like, well, I think I'd go back home. I think I'm going to keep my word and go back home. So he went back home. I stayed there for a little bit, and then I saw it kind of not being a Raiford's feel. I felt bad that my dad put his hard work, sweat, tears into this, and it's not panning out what it should be. So I went look for a building, and I found this building. And I told them, well, hey, I stay here, but I'm giving you my 2-week notice of my own club. But they fired me the same day, but it's okay. Dad, I miss it. I'm going back in. He's like, in disbelief a little bit. I think I'm a girl. And he was like, you're the last baby girl. But then he got up and said, let's go for it. Well, he told me to not to be scared. Keep anything you chose to do in life, keep your 10 toes down. Don't let nobody lift them up with their decision.
They have a panache. They have a verve for entertainment and life and business, and she's just a really warm and genuine person as well, and that's what comes through in her passion for what she does.
Always vibrant, always the life of the party, you know, like when she walk in a room, everyone notice her, whether it was just her speaking to everyone or she just automatically, with whatever she had on, it was automatically people just drew attention to her.
Her smile and that loving intake that she has. She's always a loving person to whoever she runs across. Like, when she say love, love, like, most people might take it for just words, but when she says, she mean it.
Man, I'm gonna tell you, what Raiford's and what Paula is doing now as far as keeping the whole brand and image and vibe, it's definitely a cornerstone and a staple in the city of Memphis. I mean, if I can't imagine Memphis without Raiford's.
In the heart of downtown Memphis, Paula Raiford's Disco.